Industries can move to any country with an internet connection and willing workers. And Michigan's children will grow up facing competition, not just from kids in California or South Carolina, but also from young people in Beijing and Bangalore. You know, a few years ago, I saw a picture of this new reality during a visit to Google's headquarters in California. Towards the end of the tour, I was brought into a room where there was a three-dimensional...
Friedman's definition of globalization is the reality in the world in 2011. However, events from the 1800s to the 2000s both took a positive and negative toll on the process. Based on Friedman's definition of globalization, the world has decreased in size through major events in history, most enabling, however some hindering the process. Beginning in the Industrial Revolution, the world became more able to travel and access other things easier. Following the period of the Industrial Revolution, as people began to group together based on a desire to create a place for their race, religion, or background, nationalism formed, hindering the process of globalization, because people were not open to other countries and their technology. The creation and empowerment of countries and its people led to countries desiring expansion. As countries expanded, imperialized locations took on customs of government, economic markets, and telecommunication technology. Because of the fear that they would be imperialized, countries began to amp up their militaries and power, hindering globalization as there was only fear between countries. The mix of enlarged militaries, national pride, and desire for expansion led to the Great War. It hindered the process of globalization as it created a split between the world's superpowers and led to harsh relationships between multiple countries. With the large amount of debt that Germany faced, governmental and economic issues began to form, leading people to desire change in government of the countries. The change in government quickly spread throughout the world, helping globalize new governmental and economic systems and policies. World War II helped the process of globalization as it brought together and connected countries in order to fight against Hitler's power. Although fighting had stopped in Europe, the US and Japan were still at war. The technology of the atomic bomb was spread through countries after Truman decided to drop the atomic bomb twice in Japan. Ending with the Cold War, globalization is now at a prime place as the technology and science behind nuclear weapons was rapidly spreading to the world's superpowers. The Industrial Revolution was the first time period in which globalization was able to happen. As settlements began to create and use more machinery, there were changes in social, political, and economic ideas and ways. The creation of the steam engine allowed for people to travel farther and more easily. Steam engines are another example of how some changes brought by industrialization led to even more changes in other areas. By creating the steam engine, people were now able to move around to other places, allowing for the interweaving of societies and technology by using trains and ships powered by the steam engine. Along with the invention of the steam engine came the locomotive. And finally, by making travel easier, railroads encouraged country people to take distant city jobs. Like a locomotive racing across the country, the Industrial Revolution brought rapid and unsettling changes to people's lives. Just like the steam engine, the locomotive allowed for people to travel easier. They were able to expand their living environment and take jobs in cities rather than living in confined countrysides in which people had to farm as their job. With people came technologies and ideas that were now able to travel farther and faster. As the Industrial Revolution allowed for faster, easier, and farther traveling, people started exchanging ideas more commonly. Spreading quickly, democratic ideas as well as the growing middle class provided a desire for change in government. People were now united by their commonalities and a desire for democratic government. Although nationalism allowed for a drastic change in government, it hindered the process of globalization because nationalistic feelings sometimes led a group to turn against outsiders. Because nationalistic feelings led to coldness between groups of people and nations, technology and ideas were not able to travel faster or farther than ever before, hindering globalization. New nationalistic pride and the desire to expand nations guided countries to imperialism. Nations desired larger land and expanded governmental rule. Their desire grew out of a strong sense of national pride. As the competition intensified, each country was determined to plant its flag on as much of the world as possible. The sense of national pride created a desire for countries to expand because they wanted to be the best and the biggest country. The desire of expansion of nations allowed for countries to share technology and ways of communicating. As countries feared imperialization, they began to enlarge their armies and enhance military powers. It was now a race to see who could have the biggest and best army and military power. By having a large army and strong power, people of countries felt more patriotic, but smothering their nationalism was a huge bout of fear, as militarism also frightened some people. The fear of others attacking their own countries led people to feel scared and mistrust towards other nations, blocking communication and hindering globalization. As a result of the buildup of fear, militarism, and many tangled alliances, World War I was sparked and began years of fighting. As fighting began, countries created and broke many alliances. Main powers grabbed countries as fast as they could. For example, India supplied troops to fight alongside British rulers. Meanwhile, the Ottoman Turks and later Bulgaria allied themselves with Germany and the Central Powers. Once the war ended and the Central Powers and Germany lost, coldness was fueled between powers as Germany was blamed for the war. As countries stopped communication, globalization was hindered as there was no chance to exchange new ideas and technology. Although the war hindered globalization, the interwar period promoted it, as it mended relationships between countries as well as led to many changes in government and economic ways. During post-World War I, countries gathered together to create the League of Nations and the Treaty of Versailles. The League of Nations was based off of Woodrow Wilson's 14 points. It was created to be an international association whose goal would be to keep peace among nations. By creating the League of Nations and establishing peace between various countries, the communication flowed between countries. Communication between countries allowed for the exchanging and interweaving of technology and markets of multiple countries. Along with the positive changes in relationships, the treaty also led to changes in economic and governmental ruling after Germany crumbled under extreme war debt. Although it was harsh, people turned to fascism. It promised to revive the economy and to restore national pride. Germany's government and economy were able to restore itself as the people looked to fascism for help. The stabilized government and economic system allowed Germany to get out of its World War I debt and allowed them to reconnect with other countries, promoting globalization as the countries were now able to rely on and communicate with Germany.
Legends of old.
Along with the interwar period, World War II was also a time in which countries connected. They combined their powers to stop Hitler's expansion and invasion into other lands and countries. Although America had signed a neutrality act, they needed to aid their allies, so they signed the Lend-Lease Act. By 1941, the U.S. Navy was escorting British ships carrying U.S. arms. By connecting to the United States, the British were able to receive new military technology and were able to promote globalization as they interweaved technology and communicated through their hardships. Although the U.S. was aligned with the British, meanwhile they were fighting with the Japanese. There were multiple attacks on both the U.S. and Japanese soil that continued for many months. By the beginning of 1945, the U.S. troops had fought long and hard against the Japanese, and specifically the kamikazes, who were Japanese suicide pilots. The U.S. had gained control of Iwo Jima and Okinawa. Although they had conquered the land, the U.S. had not taken over Japanese mainland. President Truman decided that the best way to capture mainland Japan would be to drop the atomic bomb. The conflicts in World War II spurred the development of even more powerful weapons. Every new weapon causes other countries to develop weapons of similar or greater force. The creation and use of the atomic bomb spread the technology and allowed for other countries to develop similar weapons. This promoted globalization as new technologies of the atomic bomb were spread throughout the world. As the world had just been exposed to the atomic bomb, the Cold War was a time in which new technologies emerged and were spread throughout the world. As World War II came to an end, the United Nations was created, as well as the divide in the east and west of Europe known as the Iron Curtain. Although the Iron Curtain showed a split in ideas and government types, it did not affect the spreading of the technology of the atomic bomb. The United States had already had the atomic bomb, but in 1949, the Soviet Union exploded its own atomic weapon. President Truman was determined to develop a more deadly weapon before the Soviets did. The exposure to the atomic bomb, as well as the competition to be the best and have the best, allowed for globalization to reach a prime point in the late 1900s. Thomas Friedman's definition of globalization is the simple definition of globalization is the interweaving of markets, technology, information systems, and telecommunication systems in a way that is shrinking the world from a size medium to a size small and enabling each of us to reach around the world farther, faster, deeper, and cheaper than ever before, and enabling the world to reach into each of us farther, faster, deeper, cheaper than ever before. Based on his definition, the world has decreased in size through major events in history, most enabling, however, some hindering the process of globalization. The Industrial Revolution was the first spark of globalization, as new technology allowed for faster and easier travel. With the people traveled new ideas of government. Following the Industrial Revolution, nationalism formed, hindering the process of globalization as it created a coldness between nations. It also fueled a desire for expanded nations, which led to imperialism. Imperialization allowed for the spreading of new governmental ideas and technology to smaller or unimperialized countries. Fearing imperialization, countries amped up their military power, hindering the process of globalization as it created fear towards other countries. The mix of tangled alliances and militarism led to World War I. It hindered the process of globalization as it created a split between the world's most important countries and led to harsh and challenging relationships between these countries. The debt that Germany faced, along with the creation of the Treaty of Versailles and the League of Nations, allowed for new governmental ideas to be able to spread across the globe. Following the Treaty of Versailles, World War II broke out, helping the process of globalization as it united countries against enemies and created new bonds and ways of communication. After the use of the atomic bomb, the technology of nuclear weapons spread during the Cold War. The Cold War was a prime time for globalization as it spread technology and pushed countries to discover new technologies. My knees up and take it all, I'll just take it all. That's me.
And when you grow silent, I start to fall. And when you grow silent, I start to fall. And when you grow silent, I start to fall. When you grow silent, oh. And when you grow silent, I start to fall. And when you grow silent, I start to fall. And when you grow silent, I start to fall. And when you grow silent, when you grow silent, this is me on my knees.